So this question has been taken from one of the comments which was sent to me by Carvel Bell on Udemy. I think it would be better if we can just illustrate you the entire description. And he also provided me this schematic of the entire arrangement. There is this rod AB, then there is this cable or cord BC, which sort of ensures that this rod stays in the equilibrium position. What you need to do is you need to find the resultant at A as well as the tension in the cord. He has also provided me with the answers. Okay, he just wants to know what is the exact process, how do we approach. Here we go with the solution. Okay, so we are going to be solving this problem using the graphical approach. He has also asked me to draw a triangle of forces. That will be done, don't worry. Apart from that, a few bits of geometry is there. AC equals AB. So if you are making this figure, make a perfect figure, in a sense that if you take this distance as 5 centimeters, since AC is equal to AB, take this distance also as 5 centimeters at an angle of 45 degree, obviously, and then there's this cord or cable BC. Done. Can you do this? Okay, follow all of these things. And then how triangular forces will be prepared, I'll demonstrate it to you. Okay, so this rod AB is at an angle of 45 degree. How? Because of this cord BC, which keeps it in this position, right? This cord will be always under tension, and there is going to be some kind of reaction at A. This is something that we need to work out, RA and T. The answers Carvel has already provided. Let's start. This is the line of action of 250 Newton force. Okay, there is going to be the attention at this particular point. We are interested in the free body of this rod AB. So at junction B, there is going to be a tension acting in this direction. Agreed? Yes. If you watch these two forces, that's the line of action of 250 Newton force. That's the line of action of tension T. These two forces are intersecting at this very point. Now, since there are three forces acting on this rod, there is another force resultant at A acting. Since there are three forces acting on the rod and it stays in equilibrium, it essentially indicates that all the three forces must have a common point of intersection. If you don't know about this idea, let me take you back to the equilibrium of three forces. Okay, that will really help you understand this concept in a much better fashion. Take a look. We've got an L-shaped object. Let's say there is force F1, F2 and F3 acting on it. Okay, when a body is acted upon by three coplanar forces, it can be in equilibrium if either the lines of action of three forces intersect at one point. Okay, this body, L-shaped body, can stay in equilibrium as long as the three forces are, or the lines of action of the three forces are intersecting at a common point. This is that intersection. Okay, as long as the three forces are concurrent, the body or the L-shaped object stays in equilibrium. It's something like this. And when that is so, let me bring F1 over to this side, then F2, tail of F2 onto the head of F1, here it is, and the tail of F3, this tail of F3 onto the head of F2, here we go. If this is the case, body stays in equilibrium, three forces are acting on it, then all the three forces must form a closed triangle. This is the logic with which we are going to be solving our problem. Here we go. Where are we? Here it is. Second force. So the third force resultant at A or reaction at A must pass through the intersection of both tension and 250 Newton force, and it is going to happen in this manner. I hope I've made myself absolutely clear, and this is a pure case of equilibrium of three forces. Now what's up? Now start the approach of graphics. Here we go. What did I just do? I have just a second, made a line, okay, with an arrow. This is the arrowhead. This is the tail. This is 50 millimeter long. What? 50 millimeter. This is a scale that you need to take. We are following the graphical approach. Okay. Then, as you have made a pure diagram, Okay, we're following the geometry. These two lines are equal. This angle is 45 degree. The next thing that you've got to do is you have to make a line which is absolutely parallel to this tension T. Okay, or this line BC, you can say. You are going to place this tension T in such a manner that its tail is here onto the head of 250 Newton force. Okay, like this. Tail is going to be somewhere here. I'm going to be fixing it, don't worry. And then you've got this reaction A. Okay, the tail of reaction A or resultant at A is going to be not the tail. The third force, this is the third force, final side of the triangle. Its head will be on the tail of 250 Newton force. Something of this sort, right? Let me just give you a demonstration again. Now, tension T, place it. The line of action should be touching this arrowhead in this fashion. Okay. Again, you've got this final resultant at A. The line of action should be touching this tail of 250 Newton force. All aspects covered. Now you just need to fine tune, shift this tension T slightly towards the back along the line of action, and this resultant A along this line of action in the upward direction slightly. So this finishes your force triangle, and with its help, you can easily calculate these two forces, both RA and T. How this can be done? Take a look. 50 mm is 250 Newton. So 1 mm is equal to 5 Newtons. That means divide both sides by 50. This is what you get. Now, I have followed a graphical approach. Once you make this triangle, you will observe the value of RA works out as 80 millimeters. If you want, I can show this to you on AutoCAD. Just a second. Okay, so watch here. This 250 Newtons, this was taken as 50 millimeters. Can you see this? 50. Okay. This RA has worked out as, just click on it. This has worked out as 80.0103. You won't be getting such exact values. Rather, it's 80 millimeters. And as far as this T is concerned, let me just give you a measurement. This T is going to work out as 46.19. That is close to 46. Okay, so these are the values which I have got, and this is your arrangement. Okay, these two sides are equal, right? Okay, anyways, I think we should get back to the presentation. Here we go. So this is 80 millimeters. It can also be written as 80 into 1 millimeter, and 1 millimeter is equivalent to 5 Newtons. So instead of writing this 1 millimeter, substitute by 5 Newtons. 80 into 5 Newtons is 400 Newtons, and that's the answer. Secondly, take a look at this tension T. It worked out as 46 millimeters, right? So 46 into 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter is 5 Newtons. Do the math. This is what you get, 230 Newtons. As far as the resultant's direction at A is concerned, okay, you can place a protractor over here, and with respect to this horizontal, you can do the measurement. If you watch carefully, this resultant A is making an angle of, this is 60 degrees, so slightly less than 60, 59, 58. 58 degrees is your answer. So the resultant is making an angle of 58 degrees with the horizontal. And these were the answers which Mr. Carvel Bill had provided. I hope this solution has helped you understand a very important concept of engineering mechanics, which says that if three forces are acting on the body and the body stays in equilibrium, then those three forces are concurrent. They must have a common point of intersection, or their lines of action must have a common point of intersection. And if that is so, they are going to form a closed triangle. Thank you, everyone.